Welcome back to Rob's Feed. My name's Rob, and this is episode number 38. Today is Tuesday, the 20th of April, and it's not going to be for long by the time I finish talking here. It will be Wednesday, the 21st of April. I don't know when you're actually going to get to see this, because I can't upload it, because I have wireless 4G internet, and here's my modem. It's the Motorola modem, and see, it's searching for a signal. It doesn't have a signal until those all go solid, and it's been searching for the signal for the last half an hour. No, I'm sorry, it's been an hour, and I can't do anything. That's actually why I decided to kill the time here talking to you. Not that it's killing time, but I'm unable to do anything else. I can't research anything. I can't read you any articles. I can't do anything because I rely too much on the internet. And I don't even have television hooked up in this apartment of mine. I watch streaming video through Hulu or Comedy Central or MSNBC or whatever, and I won't be able to do any of those either. All I can take advantage of is whatever is in my iTunes right now. So that's why I'm here talking to you about what's going on in my life now. I actually probably wouldn't have done this until tomorrow, but might as well get a jump on it. But it is once a week or so that the internet does go out. It's usually around 2:30, 3 o'clock in the morning, and it's probably about 20 minutes or so. And I've just gotten used to that because nobody would know that it's even out except for me, of course, being a 24-hour person. I guess they have to do maintenance on it every once in a while. But this is a bigger outage. This is not the same thing. It's just baffles me, and we'll see. We'll keep our fingers crossed and see how long it takes for me to get back. So as long as I'm without internet right now, I'll talk to you about some of the wonderful things on the internet for Rob's Feed. We're really pleased, really happy, and really want to give a welcome to people who have been finding this podcast through the services of Blip TV. That's blip.tv. If you want to follow along through Blip, it's hard for me to say that, but it's very worthwhile. It's robsfeed.blip.tv. And I put up all the episodes earlier. Well, it was on the 12th, and it's been a big number of people have been watching through there. Welcome to all of you, and thanks for checking us out. So now Rob's Feed has another point of distribution. So let's see, we're in iTunes, we're on YouTube, we're in MySpace, we're at Vidler.com. And now even blip.tv. So that's pretty great. I'm real pleased about that. But as always, I want to ask you, please, 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 if you happen to subscribe, if you happen to get this podcast through iTunes or YouTube, you can subscribe there. You can subscribe at any of these. But iTunes and YouTube ask for you to subscribe, to rate, and to comment. So please do that for me. I'd appreciate it. Now, just this week, I heard about a new service that's I'm quite intrigued with. It's called goldstar.com. And I really can't read you any of the stuff on their site now because, as I said, my internet's down. But basically, what you do is you get tickets to theatrical, sporting, to events at substantial discount, usually half price, from what I can tell. And you enter in your zip code, and they'll tailor it so it's stuff that's near you that you can get to. And here I am in Chicago. I've been in Chicago a long time, but there are places I have never even heard of that I discovered through goldstar.com. And one of them is the Storefront Theater in the Loop, which from what I can tell is sponsored by the City of Chicago Department of Cultural Affairs. And it's a space for local theatrical companies. There's a company called Hypocrite Theater. Never heard of them either. But from what I read, they do a really nice job with their production that's currently going on in the Broadway musical Cabaret. So, like I said, I've never been there before. I don't want to treat somebody to something I don't know what it's going to be. But I thought I'd check it out. And I'm getting such a deal. For this Thursday night, I will be, although I'll be alone, I'll be seeing Cabaret for $12.50 plus a $4 service fee. What did I say? It was the last ticket, ticket available through that program for that performance. So if I like it, I'll go on a date with it, with them to it in the following weeks. I guess it's running through May. But check back if you want to hear my experiences. This is different than sitting in auditorium seating, because I'll go to the box office and they'll show me a little map of the seating, and I will select where I want to sit. And the neat thing is, this is the seating, as I understand it, is arranged as if I were a patron of the Cabaret. So I'm really, really looking forward to that. Cabaret was an Academy Award-winning movie in the early 70s. I think it was like 1972, starring Liza Minnelli with Joel Grey as the master of ceremonies. And it was an excellent piece. It really, really was. I have that on my iTunes hard drive. I might choose to watch it. In the late 90s, it was redone and opened at Studio 54 in New York in a nightclub setting, with the great Alan Cumming as the master of ceremonies and Natasha Richardson, the late Natasha Richardson, I'm sorry to say, as Sally Bowles. I have a recording of that on my iTunes. I happen to see the same version in Milwaukee. And it was funny because the woman playing Sally Bowles in this version, by the way, it's more gritty, it's more erotic, it's probably more true to life than the motion picture was. But the funny thing was that the woman who played Sally Bowles in the version that we saw, his name is Kate Schindel. Does that sound familiar? Well, first off, my name's Rob Schindel. Kate Schindel was from Illinois. She was Miss Illinois. She became Miss America at the time I was here in Chicago and working in the bar, and the bar happened to have the Miss America pageant on. And the joke all around the bar was that Robbie was crowned Miss America because of the similarity between Kate Schindel, and Robert Schindel. But be that as it may, it's a real sidetrack and not worth anything but a little anecdote. But next time you talk to me, I will have seen it, and I'll be so happy to be able to tell you. I really want to like it. I really want to say it's good. So without the internet, I guess that's all I'm going to say.